श्रीचैतन्यमनोभृष्टं स्वापरान्तिकां वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरौ श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुवैष्णवंश श्रीरूपां सागरजाता सहगणारघुनाथं पिथां सजीवां साद्वैतं सावधूता भवितनासहितां कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणालिता श्रीशाखान्वितं च इति कृष्णाकरुणासिन्धो यदो जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिकाकान्ता राधाकान्त नमोऽस्ते भक्तकाञ्चन गौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी विश्वभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये पञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्रीकृष्णचैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्रीअद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
in the spiritual world of Vaikuntha, there's an eternal festival going on. And the Srimad Bhagavatam gives details about how the residents of the spiritual world travel from place to place, but in flower airplanes, and there are no business trips, pleasure trips only. On the other hand, in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that the material world is bhutalayana shashvatam, it's miserable and temporary. Somehow or other, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, we have fallen into this ocean of material existence. And after 8 million species of life, one has the opportunity to come to the human form of life. Jaladhar Mahalakshani Sara Shadunchiti. The Vedas describe all the various species of life, 800,000, before one comes to the human form of life. But when one reaches the human form of life, one has an opportunity like never before. Vide hamadyam sulabham sudulabham plabham. The human body in Vrideham is very rare. It's awarded by the material nature after a long time. And it's a boat by which one can cross over the ocean of nations, the ocean of suffering, which is the material world. Vrideham adhyam sulabham sudulabham. Lavam sukalpam guru karnadaram. This is a verse spoken by Krishna to Uddhava in the 11th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and he says, to fly across the ocean in this boat, one requires a captain. Because if you go out without any knowledge of the sea, you're sunk. You also need wind in your sails. And Krishna says this wind comes in the form of the instructions given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the Shastra, and by the sadhus, and by the gurus. So with this able boat, and with winds in one's sail, one can cross over the ocean with the help of the captain. So human life is meant for this progress. Out of darkness, the Shastras are calling to us, saying, Tamasima Jyotirgama. Don't stay in the darkness of the material world. Wake up, come back to the light. See the light and come back to the light. So today, we're celebrating and initiating formally this process of determinedly going back to Godhead. All of you today who have come here are on a journey. And this is one of the most important steps in this journey back home, back to Godhead. Today we're witnessing, and so is the Lord, an initiation ceremony. And before the lotus feet of His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, I offer my humble obeisances to Sri Sri Radha Madan Mohan, to all the devotees who are assembled here today. Please shower your blessings on us as we embark on this path back to Godhead, especially for the initiates today who will be making vows to maintain throughout their life, by which they can attract the mercy and attention of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The process of initiation is mentioned by Bhaktivinoda Thakur in an essay he wrote called Pancha Samskara. And there are five stages of initiation. The first is called tapa. Tapa means heat. It also means tapasya, to perform some austerity. And in the beginning, one must have a feeling that this material world is not my home. One must come to understand that by adjustment in this material world, moving higher, lower, to the left side or the right side, I won't find any satisfactory situation, and that I'm not meant to be here. One must then repent within one's heart for having spent so many lifetimes, so much time wasted in the material world. This is the feeling of tapasya within one's heart, tapa. And traditionally there's the process of following some restrictions so that one isn't involved so much in the material energy, tapa. And then comes pundra, which means to apply the urdhva pundra, which means this Vaishnava tila. In the Sri Sampradaya, they brand the body with hot brands, with the signs of Vishnu. But we're not doing that today, right? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended decorating one's body with the holy names of the Lord and with this urdhva pundra, this tilak, which indicates the footprint of the Lord and one's eternal dedication to the service of the Lord. When anyone sees this, wherever you go, they become purified according to the Shastra. And this pundra also means that we identify ourselves outwardly as a devotee. We're showing ourselves to the world, expressing that this is my path in life, going back home, back to God. The world needs this, needs the representatives, the Vishnu Dutas, those who are messengers of the Lord, who are like agents. Policeman wears his or her uniform to show I'm here to protect and serve. And similarly, the Vaishnavas, they show externally to announce that I'm here on behalf of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yat kodoshi arashna shiyach dohoshi tadasi yat yat tapasyasi kuntiya tat kudushva madarpanam. The devotees are absorbed in giving everything to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whatever is in their possession, and assisting others in doing that also. And after pundra, pundra comes nama. This nama means what we're performing today, what we're engaging in, is the Harinam initiation. It means that we accept a new name. In America, the federal government has a system called the Federal Witness Protection Program. When someone is mixed up in some kind of illegal activity and turn state evidence, or turn state evidence against others who are, their lives are in peril. And the government gives them a new name and moves them to a new location so that the gangsters can't find them and kill them, which they will do. So similarly today, when we take a new name, you're hiding yourself from the vision of Maya. Of course, she will try to find it. She's all pervading. But we're taking on a new identity, an identity as servants of the Lord. And that will be indicated by the name Das for the men and Dasi for the women. This is a very relishable term, a very relishable name, to have Das or Dasi. I remember the first time I saw the Back to Godhead magazine, and I was so attracted to the devotees, looking at how they were working hard in various services for God, and they looked so happy. And then I saw that all their names had Das or Dasi at the end of it, and I said, I want one of those names. It seemed like such a desirable and exalted name, Das or Dasi, to actually have that title bestowed upon one, that one is a servant of the Lord. And it is. This is the most exalted of all positions in this world. The demigods who prayed to Krishna within the womb before he appeared in the world said that the only safe position in this world is to reestablish one's relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. All other imagined forms of perfection are fallible, and one will fall down from those positions. But we take shelter, understanding that this world is unstable, and that any other kind of endeavor or connection in this world will not last. But after all, our connection with the Supreme Personality of God is eternal and our only substantial possession. The Sri Brahma Samhita says where we have an eternal kinship with the Lord. Now that's been forgotten. And therefore, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Satya Kabunoy, Shravanadi Shuddha Chitte Kari Udoy. That eternal connection, relationship that we have with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, although now obscured, is awakened when our heart is purified through the process of Shravanam and Kirtanam. And therefore, we take the Nam, the name of Krishna. We receive a name, Dasa Dasi, that I am the servant of God. And we also make a vow that we will take full shelter of the holy name. This is the meaning of Harinam initiation. Actually, traditionally, there is no exact initiation of the time of giving the Harinam. But Srila Prabhupada, especially when he came to America, performed a grandiose ceremony to impress upon his students that something big was happening. And after all, the Shastra says something big is happening. When one decides to dedicate one's life with single-pointed attention to chanting God's name, this is the biggest of all events. According to Devahuti in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Yannama Deha Shravanad Kirtana, Yapravanad Yasmanami Apikuchit, Shvado Pisadyo Shravanaya Savanaya Kopate. The great saint Devahuti says that for those who are engaged in this chanting and hearing of God's name, they are qualified as Brahmins. In other words, they're qualified to perform sacrifice, savanaya. There are many sacrifices mentioned in the Vedas which are available only to the Brahmins. And the Brahmins have to come through a certain channel, they have to be trained in a certain way. But she says that even a person who is a dog eater, shvadho means a dog cooker, shvadho, pisadyo, savanaya kalpate, immediately when one begins this process of chanting God's names and hearing about Him. One destroys one's prarabdha karma. That is, whatever situation we're born into means we've accumulated over many lifetimes karma. And it's now manifest in the form of this body. This is called prarabdha karma. That becomes neutralized by the process of chanting the names of God. And one becomes qualified immediately. Not that one has to wait for another life. Not that one has to continue chanting for a long time. But if one begins the process of chanting Hare Krishna, one becomes qualified to perform the sacrifice, which means that that person is already a Brahmin. And then she says, Aho Bhattashva Patito Gadhyanya Jiva Gre Bhartitinama Kunjam. Kepustapaste Juhubu Sasna Arya Brahmana Churnama Grananjiyete. Oh, how wonderful it is, she says, Aho Bhattashva Patito Gadhyan. That if somebody is in a low position of life, the lowest position, again, she mentions the dog eater. But says the holy name without offense, even one time. It means, jiva agre means they say it even a little bit or even one time, the acharyas say. Hare Krishna, everyone say.
Hare Krishna.
Those who utter this name of God, Hare Krishna, they are considered to have already passed through all kinds of Vedic ritual sacrifices, studying the Vedas, going to all the holy places, and these people become glorified as better than Brahmins. Actually, they're situated in a transcendental position by offenselessly chanting the holy name of the Lord. So if it hadn't been performed before the initiation ceremony or taking initiation of the holy name, how do we justify? Actually, the Shastra does say that there is a Harinam initiation. The great commentator on Srimad Bhagavatam, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, in his commentary on the sixth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the story of Ajamil, who became saved by incidentally saying the name of the Lord, Narayan, at the time of death. And he was saved from a wholly sinful life. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur reports that in chanting the holy names, one should take shelter of a Vaishnava. This is our system, as Krishna tells Arjuna in the Adi Purana. One who says he's my devotee is not my devotee. But one who says, I'm a devotee of your devotee, that person is my devotee. In Chaitanya Bhagavat, Vrindavan Das Thakur says, when one becomes a devotee of Lord Narayan, there's some question about whether he or she will attain perfection. But if one becomes the devotee of Lord Narayan, there's no question. Definitely, that person will be delivered. And therefore, in the Harinam initiation, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, to accept the name of Krishna, the chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, through the disciplic succession from his spiritual master, keeps one from avoiding the third offense, which is to disobey the orders of the spiritual master. And one very quickly makes advancement in the process of chanting the holy names. Jiva Goswami says a similar thing in his commentary called the Bhagavat Sandarbha. So today is called the Harinam initiation, when the devotees will accept a new name with Das or Dasi at the end, indicating their service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And they will also make vows to regularly chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra every day. This comes through our line of teachers, especially the six Goswamis of Vrindavan, who were direct disciples of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and showed by their example how to follow the process of bhakti. Srinivasacharya, in his glorification of these disciples, the six Goswamis, has mentioned Sankhya Purvaka Nama Dhananapiti Kalava Sankhito. That every day they would count how many times they're chanting, how many times they're bowing down, how many prayers they're uttering, and so forth. Sankhya means to count. Purvaka Nama Dhananapiti Kalava Sankhito. This Prabhupada called numerical strength. Because the mind fluctuates from one day to the next. Sometimes it's hard to recognize your mind. One day it says, yes, this is a good idea, let's perform devotional service. Next day, next year, 5 years later, it says, what are you doing this for? You should be selling soap. With something much more valuable than chanting Hare Krishna all day long. The mind can be one's best friend or worst enemy. Therefore, we must take shelter of a higher authority than the mind. First, we take shelter of Shastra. The Shastra Viramutsri Javartate Kamakarata Nasasidam Avatnamuti Nasukham Naparambhatid. Without taking shelter of Shastra as our authority, there's no happiness, no peace, and there's no ultimate destination in the spiritual world. It's business as usual in the material world, because it's for the sake of the mind that we stay here lifetime after lifetime. So, under the Shastra, and under the order of the spiritual master, who says 16 rounds, that's the vow, that's what must be kept. Then we keep the mind at bay, and every day we say, I'm not following the mind, I'm following my spiritual master. I'm following the Shastra. Much better idea. And that's what you're all doing today. You're taking this vow. I'm coming under this protection of the Shastra, the spiritual master, the sadhus. I'm going to follow that path. And by that, as Krishna recommends to Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita, evam buddhi param buddhva samstrat yatmanamatmana jahi shatra mahabaho kama rupatrashiva. You rise up and use your higher intelligence to conquer the lower intelligence. This is buddhi yoga. To take the Shastra, to take the orders of the spiritual master and the sadhus and say, that's who I'm following, no matter what. I will not stop. I will not ever break my vow. We visited the Bhajan Kirtir of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, one of the great devotees in our preceptorial line in Navadvipa. And there we were hearing about his exalted teachings. And among them was the edict to his disciples that you should remain steady at all costs in your practice of devotional service, even at the cost of your own life. All the devotees who were hearing that edict took it to heart and thought, how to apply that? Remain steady in your vow, even at the cost of your own life. But if a vow is to be taken, this is the one to take. In the age of Kali Yuga, dedicating oneself, putting oneself under the protection of the holy name of the Lord is the most recommended by Shastra of any other instruction. And it was shown by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was performing the Acharya Lila, showing how a devotee must move in this world in order to take perfection, to attain perfection. He himself accepted the name from his spiritual master, Śrīla Īśvara Puri. We know this because when he went off to Gaya, he wasn't quite a devotee yet. All the devotees in Navadvipa were praying, let me, my pandit, become a devotee, then the Sankirtan movement will really take off. Because he's so bright and he's so beautiful. But unfortunately, he's not a devotee. Me, my pandit, goes to Gaya. He meets Śrīla Īśvara Puri. He accepts the holy name, and he also accepts Diksha. And then he comes back a changed person, intoxicated with the holy name. In fact, he went back to his spiritual master, according to Kaviraj Goswami in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he said, what kind of name did you give me? I have to check in with you now because I'm not sure if this is the right thing. And his spiritual master says, why are you asking? He said, because this name has driven me crazy. Now I'm chanting Hare Krishna I become like a madman. Sometimes I fall on the ground and I cry. I don't care for outsiders in the world. People think I'm crazy, and I think maybe I am too. Srila Ishwarapuri said, very good. Very good. Very good. And then he gave Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam, which he said is the essence of all the teachings of Srimad Bhagavatam. Evam vrata sva priyanama kirtya jatana rago chita chita rucha asatyato rauti rauti gaiti imadavam nidhiti lokabhaya. That when one takes this vow to take shelter of the holy name, evam vrata, and he continues to chant the holy name of the Lord, then the heart will melt. Drutta chitta means the chitta, the heart, the consciousness, it melts away. And then one becomes indifferent to outsiders. One may dance. In fact, I think we do that sometimes, right? Dance in public? Who does that? A lot of people walk by with a tie and a briefcase, they, what is this? Dancing in the street? You've got to go to work. And we're thinking, dance, dance. And sometimes the devotees show emotions like crying, rolling on the ground. Of course, Prabhupada didn't show these kinds of emotions very much. He held them in check. And in the commentary to that verse, the great acharyas say that some devotees who are very exalted show this external symptom of crying, laughing, dancing, and so forth in ecstasy when their heart melts, and others don't. But Madhvacharya says there are two symptoms of the advanced devotee that are always present. One is steadiness, and the other is mukti prasada, which means that what comes from their mouth is meant for the benefit of others. Mukti prasada, what they speak is mercy for others. It's meant to benefit them, because no more envy within the heart. The holy name is so powerful, says Sukha Goswami, that even if one chants it unconsciously, one can become greatly benefited, and at the time of any danger, one can take shelter of the holy name of the Lord. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he set off on his journey for South India, he began to sing, Krishna, 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 hey! And similarly, the devotees, they wrap this wreath of the holy name around their neck, and they wear it always. Upon waking up, they chant Hare Krishna. Upon going to sleep, they chant Hare Krishna. When someone gives them prasad, they say Hare Krishna. When they lose all their money, they say Hare Krishna. That's the way to get through this world. Hare Krishna, everyone.
Hare Krishna.
In fact, that's the only way to take shelter of the holy name of the Lord. And when one makes this vow that I'm going to chant Hare Krishna, no matter what else happens, then one develops a relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And all good fortune comes. Shreya Kayarava Chandrikami Pavana, the white lotus of good fortune opens in one's life. So all of you today are very, very fortunate. We all feel it. We see it in you. We're dancing in our hearts to watch how you've taken the holy name under the guidance of your gurus, most particularly Lokajakshapu and Vidarbha Sutta, who I've seen have guided you from the time of your spiritual infancy through their steady teachings and example and love and kindness they administer from the heart. And from this wonderful community of devotees, well, I just sit and I watch in awe of all of you, how you work together to make such a beautiful environment. The deity worship here is immaculate. The way everything's set up here, I see the pamphlets when I walk in the door, everything, there's attention to detail. All of this out of love and devotion, just to see this result. Ultimately, this is it. We don't care so much about how things look as much as we care about how the hearts of the devotees are changing. And now we see that both things are happening. So this is the best sign in the world. when so many devotees are coming forward and saying that I'm dedicating my life to the holy name. Shraddha Shakti Vishwas Kohe Sridha Nishchoy Krishne Bhakti Koila Sarva Karma Krita Hoy. This means faith. That I understand Krishna's just not one thing or a nice thing, he's everything. And his name is everything. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur says there's nothing to be had in the 14 worlds but the holy name. How about that? When one has that growing faith and understanding within one's heart that there's nothing to be had in the 14 worlds except the holy name, that person is qualified to move forward with this Harinam initiation. This is the qualification. Shraddha, faith. Where you place your heart, you're placing it squarely under the protection of the holy name. Now there's a difference in the effect that the holy name will have on us according to how we conduct ourselves. There's a way in which we can organize our lives and conduct ourselves so that we'll be more attractive to the holy name. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, once when visiting a temple of Lord Vishnu, didn't go up to see the deity, but stood at the very back of the temple near the Garuda Stumbo. And one of his disciples came over and said, Guru Maharaj, please come up, you can have darshan now. And he said, I'm standing next to Garuda. The Lord will look out and see his devotee, Garuda, and then he'll see me here, standing under the protection of Garuda. I'm not here to see the Lord, I'm here to be seen by the Lord. This is the prerogative of the devotee, to make him or herself more attractive so that the devotee will see him or her. And again, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur says, don't try to see God, but try to act in such a way that he'll want to see you. And to that end, Padma Purana says, Atashi Krishnanama Adina Babe Grayanindre Sevan Mukhi Hiti Voto Swayameva Spurakida. Here's the easy path, the simple direct path to understanding and realizing God, to attracting his attention. And that is, control the tongue by chanting Hare Krishna and taking Krishna Prasad, the holy name, on the tongue, constantly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted this Harinam initiation and he took shelter of his spiritual master to continue the process of chanting. And if one does this, that is, take the instructions of the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Bhagavad Gita, especially we have a sacred mountain of literature. Srila Prabhupada miraculously gave us these cherished books that we have for thousands of years to come that give us perfect instruction how to move forward on the path. And he also made a society in which there are hundreds, no thousands of devotees who can show the example and who have also followed these instructions and come with their own realizations ready to give them to us to guide us on the path. So by chanting the holy name and taking the good guidance of this one's spiritual masters, one can make steady progress, attract the attention of Krishna by this chanting of the holy name, and attain all perfection in life. In the fourth stage of initiation, one comes to accept mantra. Mantra means the 18-syllable Gopal mantra, which is in our sampradaya, which is passed down from the time of Brahma. Uvacha puritastasmai tasya divya sarasati kama krishna govinda he govindani balabaya priyadhanir mantram ketasati priyam tapaskam tapa ekena tapasiddhya govishyati. Divine Saraswati appeared before Brahma and said, take this mantra, and gave him the 18-syllable mantra, and said, if you perform this, you'll attain all perfection. This is your tapasya. And the purport, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta writes, Its purport is clear. Wow. My favorite purport. Its purport is clear. So take this clear purport. Chant the holy names with full faith. You're following in the footsteps of the great acharyas. Ayamuktakalayadu pasyamanam. The liberated souls do this activity. It's not meant for this world. It's meant for the spiritual world. And if you chant the holy name, you'll be under the protection of the spiritual world, the internal energy, and all the great devotees of the Lord. And Lord Krishna will be with you always. After mantra, which one becomes qualified for after chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra steadily for some time, becoming learned a little bit in the Shastra, then one comes to yaga, which means one can perform deity worship. And as we discussed the other night, this is vital in the process of advancing in devotional service. In the age of Kali Yuga, according to Shastra, everyone's polluted. Prayanao paishasabhya kalavasmindivedana manda samanda matayo manda pagyati pagyata. In the Iron Age of Kali, men have but short lives. They're quarrelsome, lazy, misguided, unlucky, and above all, always disturbed. That means cell phones. So what are the chances of actually chanting Hare Krishna steadily with a purified mind without offenses? Chances are not very good, say our acharyas. Therefore, they recommend that one take this brahminical initiation after nama and begin to perform deity worship. Because while performing deity worship, one must stay in a clean state 24 hours a day. Right? You can ask him. He's clean 24 hours a day. From morning till night. He's always chanting mantras, always taking baths. And then if he touches something, he'll make sure he takes baths. Because he's attending to the Lord. Don't mind. Just that. And we develop a personal relationship with Krishna through the deity worship. These five stages, Prabhupada enacted throughout the world, bringing in people from all classes. Some were crazy, some were lazy, unlucky, whatever they were, he brought them up to the standard by teaching this process of chanting Hare Krishna, first and foremost. And then, as the good qualities began to pour out of these devotees and the bad qualities diminished, he would then give them the mantra, the sacred mantra, which is chanted at least three times a day at the Sangha. So, the quality of chanting Hare Krishna is particularly important. One may go on chanting Hare Krishna for millions of years, but one must also do something else. And that is dedicate oneself to avoiding offenses. Aparadha. And one offense is to blaspheme devotees who have dedicated their lives to propagating the holy name of the Lord all over the world. That means that we're the recipients of the mercy of the Lord through the devotees. Bhakti Devi distributes herself through the preachers, the Madhyamadikaris, who go out into the world and they discriminately find people who are open and they give the holy name. That's why we're here, because of the great devotees of the Lord. Srila Prabhupada came and then he empowered his followers to do the same thing. And if we say something against them, we're biting the hand that feeds us. And this is not very much liked. In fact, it's abhorred by the Supreme Personality of Godhead and any pure devotee that one utters vilification against the devotees of the Lord or spreading the holy name for our benefit all over the world. One should also understand that Krishna is the source of everyone and everything, and there are no other entities in this world under whom we need or must take shelter, or we should never glorify on an equal level. And at the same time, we should see that everyone is in connection with the Supreme Personality of God, and therefore we should respect them as such. That includes the demigods. Another offense is to disobey the orders of the spiritual master, and this one's very nice. Because once you have the order, you simply follow it. And that's our nature, everyone's nature. Living entities want to follow. That's why people want a king. That's why people really wanted a president of the United States who was really good. And they become disappointed when they see that they have some moral lapse. People become disappointed. Because people really want to follow. Because we're followers, we're servants of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And when we can discover that line of instruction that comes from the Supreme Personality of Godhead through the disciplined succession, then we become fortified and we have something to hold on to. So one should not disobey the orders of the spiritual master, but follow them very carefully, then one will be protected. One should also not criticize the Vedic literature, because the Vedic literature is a huge project meant to reach out to save all people. And in all of its forms, whether the Shastras are in the mode of ignorance, passion, or goodness, they're meant to bring people closer to the Supreme Personality of God, and we should not disregard the Shastra. We should also not imagine the name of the Lord. There's no need to. We should simply take shelter of the descriptions of the holy name given in Shastra and take full shelter of the holy name. We should not interpret the holy name. We should also not commit sins on the strength of chanting the holy name of the Lord. This is like an elephant's bathing, and or drinking water underwater on a fast day. We should also not indiscriminately give the holy name, but we should consider who is qualified. That is, not preach the holy name forcefully to those who are not interested. This is also considered an offense. There's a lot more details about that instruction, because someone might ask, well, why do we even go out then if we don't know? We'll talk about that later. Tenth offense is to maintain material attachments even after understanding so many instructions on this matter. So maintenance is a hard job. To maintain a garden takes a lot of work. And to maintain a job takes a lot of work. Don't maintain material desires. It's a lot of work for nothing. Better to maintain your sadhana and maintain your faith in the holy name. And the root cause of all the offenses, according to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is to be inattentive while chanting. So apply this one principle. Always pay attention when you're chanting your rounds, especially in chanting Hare Krishna. Give attention to the holy name. And just by that one act every day, you'll have inspiration in your heart, you'll get knowledge and detachment, and you'll feel advancement just from this one activity, which is so exalted. So, we are going now to invite each one of you to come up, wait 1 second, and you'll come up. Offer your obeisance to your spiritual master, then we're going to hand you the microphone. And if you would please make your vows, which you all know, the vows you're making today. Right? Okay. And then we will give you your spiritual name. And I must say, in meditating on these spiritual names, I felt great happiness. Because I was thinking that in all the aspects of devotional service, because we're in contact with the Supreme Personality of God through his names, through his paraphernalia, we become deeply affected. And we will also give you a certificate of initiation so that you can prove that you were initiated. Otherwise, you'll have to depend on so many witnesses. I thought of this a while back, and then Malati told me when she was at our house recently that Srila Prabhupada said that he wanted to have this system of giving a certificate of initiation when devotees took initiation. So I thought that we'd start here today. Others may have done it, but I'm going to give that certificate. So one by one, we'll ask you to come up and accept your beads and your new name. So we'll start with Mukesh, please come up. one thing I want to say first. I'm extremely proud that you're here today. I've watched your advancement from the very beginning. I remember the day that I met you in Sudita at Lokanji Dark's house, and I remember how you were excitedly taking to the process of Krishna consciousness. But the first day we met, slightly hesitant about a few things, but then all of a sudden you took off and your spiritual life expanded quite rapidly. And you've come to this position. So it's been a real pleasure watching you sojourn in spiritual life. What are the vows?
I chant at least 16 rounds every day. No intoxication, including tea and coffee. No meat eating, including onion and garlic. No gambling, and no incense.
Besides these, please follow the direction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur when he says, Jive Doi Krishna Nam Sara Dharma Sara. The essence of all religion is to show mercy to all living beings by widely spreading the holy name of the Lord. Please adhere to that. And also, please be very careful about how you speak. If you just control your speech, you'll be very quickly moved towards the spiritual world. Following the eternal principle of parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada's order to expand the Sankirtan movement as my life and soul, depending on the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, the Acharyas, Lord Chaitanya, and all the greatly compassionate devotees who are like wish-fulfilling trees, I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple and therefore a member of the Brahma Matra Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby award you the name Madana Murari Das.
Madana Murari Das.
And I would like to also give you a certificate of initiation. Please be careful about it. And of course, you were together the night I met you at Lokanjadani's house. And I remember that you had pulled way out in front with your chanting and your enthusiasm to take up the process of Krishna consciousness. I was instantly impressed when I saw your enthusiasm for Krishna consciousness. And I'm very happy it culminated in this relationship with them. What are your vows?
No meeting, including onion, garlic, and eggs, and no intoxication, including tea and coffee, no gambling, no illicit sex, and always obey the orders of my spiritual master. Thank you.
And how many rounds do you chant at least every day?
At least I chant 16 rounds every day.
At least? Following the eternal principle of parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada's and Lord Chaitanya's order to expand the Sankirtan movement as my life and soul, depending on their mercy, the mercy of the previous Acharyas, and all the Vaishnava devotees of the Lord who are like desired trees, I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple and therefore a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada and a member of the Brahma Matra Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby happily award you the name Radhika Nam Devi Dasi.
Hello!
Radhika Nam Akashi Singh! cut. It's been a pleasure watching how you overcome all obstacles by your staunch determination in your heart. I've seen it in every stage of life that I've seen you in so far. You meet that, whatever challenges you come to, with the determination to continue your chanting Hare Krishna and the process of Krishna consciousness so enthusiastically. And I'm very, very happy to be here with you today. Where are you now? A little closer.
I think around this time. 16 rounds, okay?
At least 16 rounds.
At least 16 rounds. And all the problems,
following the eternal principle of parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada's and Lord Chaitanya's order to expand the Sankirtan movement as my life and soul, depending on their mercy and the mercy of the previous acharyas and all the Vaishnava devotees of the Lord who are like desire trees. I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple and therefore a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada and a member of the Brahma Matva Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby happily award you the name Hari Ganga Devi Dasa.
Hari
Hari Ganga Mata Devi Devi. And here's the sentence. Sonali. I am most positive, Sunali, that you studied the Shastras in your previous life, due to your acumen for studying in this life. I also think that you must have taken care of your family very carefully in your last life in one capacity or another, because watching how your family supports you is something unprecedented. The heart of your husband and your children is something amazing to behold. And has been a major contributing factor, along with your intense desire to advance in Christian consciousness. And I'm overjoyed that you're here today and that we're beginning this process of Christian consciousness. What are your vows?
Yeah, I want to
following the eternal principle of parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada's and Lord Chaitanya's order to expand the Sankirtan movement as my life and soul, and depending on their mercy, the mercy of the previous acharyas, and all the Vaishnava devotees of the Lord who are like desire trees, I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple, and therefore a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada, and a member of the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby happily award you the name Sharanagata Devi Dasa. Sharanagata Mata Devi Devi. Thank you. I find in you a gentle soul who's very fortunate because you take shelter of good instruction. You know how to connect to good instruction and take it. You have been for many years now. Regularly hearing the Bhagavatam and the Shastra. I've also seen your enthusiasm in the holy dance that we were there together. And I'm very happy the support that you have from your family and the great determination in devotional service which has brought you here today. What are your doubts? Hold on, really close.
At least I will chant 16 rounds every day. I follow the four regulatory principles. Those are no meat eating, including onion, garlic, egg. No instant stress. No intoxication, including coffee, tea, no dining. Thank you for accepting that.
My pleasure. Following the eternal principle of Parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada's and Lord Chaitanya's order to expand the Sankirtan movements of my life and soul, and depending on their mercy, the mercy of the previous acharyas and all the Vaishnava devotees of the Lord who are like the Zayatris, I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple and therefore a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada and a member of the Brahma Matra Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby happily award you the name Akshina Mangala Devi Dasi. And last but certainly not least, Lynette. Thanks a lot. Lynette, I am so pleased to meet you and to find in you a maturity, having spent time in the material world enough to know that it's not where you want to be. Your determination in that regard is palpable. Every time I'm around you, and it inspires me to know and to watch how you come to this point with such determination, having ruled out all possibility of staying in this material world. I thank you very much. What are your vows?
Thank you, Guru Maharaj. I'll vow to camp for 16 rounds of the day. Minimum. I vow to no meat eating, including eggs, garlic, and onion. No intoxication, including coffee and tea. No yelling, and no success. And I promise to follow your orders quickly. Always.
Following the eternal principles, Parampara, taking Srila Prabhupada and Lord Chaitanya's order to expand the Sankirtan movement as my life and soul, and depending on their mercy, the mercy of the previous acharyas, and all the Vaishnavas devotees of the Lord, who are like desire trees. I am exceedingly pleased to accept you as my disciple and therefore a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada and a member of the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. I hereby happily award you the name Lalita Madhava Devi Dasa. Lalita Madhava Mataji Ki. And I wanted to just mention in 10 seconds that the instructions to please always control your tongue carefully, especially your speech. And what you eat, and to be merciful for all living entities. I meant that for all of you. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. And now our esteemed priest will perform the fire sacrifice to solemnify this process. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. So we'll do the first set of Krishna. Please take in front of you. And only you give our peace. So please don't use this finger. Just use the three fingers. And when I was just swaha. And
Tarini Ganga. Tarini Ganga.
Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishnaya
Krishna Krishnaya
Bhutale
Bhutale
Srimate
Srimate
Bhakti Vedanta
Bhakti Vedanta
Swami
Swami
Iti
Namine
Namaste
Namaste
Saraswati
Deve
Gauravani
Gauravani
Vacharine
Nirvishesha
Shunyavadi
Ashyatya Deshakarine Swaha
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 Idam Patishtha Tanjaye Idam Namaha Namohum Vishnu Padaya
Vishnu
Krishna Krishkaya
Krishna Krishkaya
Bhutale
Bhutale
Vimate
Srimate
Bhakti Siddhanta
Bhakti Siddhanta
Saraswate
Saraswate
Dinamine
Dinamine
Vashyam Bhanave Devi
Bhanave Devi
Daitaya
Daitaya
Vipadhaye
Krishna Sambandha
Vijnana
Vijnana Aine
Prabhave
Namaha
Madhurya
Ucchala
Vimadhyā
Vimānuga Pandita Srigaura Karuna Shakti Vigrahaya
Namastute
Namaste
Gauravani
Gauravani
Dinatarine
Dinatarine
Rupanuga
Virathapam
Siddhanta
Siddhanta
Harine
Swaha
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 Om Idam Param Gurave Idam Namaha Namo
Namo
Kishoraya
Sakshad Vairagya
Murtaye
Vipralambha
Prasambhode
Adam Bhujayate
Namaha
Vaha
Swaha
Swaha
Vaha
Swaha
Om Idam Patragave Idam Namaha Namo Bhakti Vinodaya
Bhakti Vinodaya
Sachidananda
Sachidananda
Namine
Gaura Shakti Sarupaya Rupanuga
Varayate
Swaha
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 Idam Mahadurve Idam Namaha Shri Gaura Avida Bhava Vumestam Indesva Tatyana Priya Vashnava Sarvabhuma Srijagadanathayate Namaha
Swaha
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 Swaha Idam Parameshri Gurave Idam Namaha Vanchakalpatarum
Vanchakalpatarum
Vashya
Vashya
Kripasindhubhya
Kripasindhubhya
Evacha
Evacha
Patitanam
Patitanam
Pavanebhyo
Vishnavibhyo
Vishnavibhyo
Namo Namaha
Namo Namaha
Swaha
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 Etam Sarvavishnavatatyadhyam idam namaham Namo Mahavadannaya
Krishna Prema
Prayate
Krishnaya
Krishnaya
Krishna Chaitanya
Krishna Chaitanya
Namne
Namne
Auratishe
Auratishe
Namaha
Namaha
Swaha
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 Idam Gauraya Idam Namaha Panchatatmatmakam Krishnam
Panchatatmatmakam Krishnam
Bhaktarupa
Sarupakam
Bhaktavataram
Bhaktakyam
Namami
Bhakta Shaktikam
Swaha
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 Swaha Om Idam Panchatatvaya Idam Namaha
E Krishna,
Karuna
Sindhu,
Dina Bandhu,
Jagatpate, Upesha, Upika Kanta, Radha Kanta, Namastute, Saha, 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 Shute Devi, Pranamami, Hari Priye, Swaha, Swaha, Swaha,
Idam Radhikaye, Idam Namaman, Jayatam,
Surato,
Angaramaman, Mandama Kirkate, Matsarvasya,
Adam Bhojo,
Shirada,
Sanasito, Sisrada, Govinda Devo, Amami, Saha, Saha, Saha,
Idam, Adivari Deva, Gwinda, Idam Nama, Sriman Rasha.
Asarambi, Ansivata, Tarasita, Krishna Venu,
Gopi Natha,
Gopinatha,
Yastunaha,
Saha,
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 Idam Prajana Deva, Gurnatha, Idam Namama, Jaya
Sri Krishna,
Chaitanya, Prabhunita,
Nanda,
Priyadvaita,
Om, Anga Hinam,
Kriyahinam Vidihinam
Bhave Astu Aksharavam Asridyam Krishna Krishna Krishadataha Yatkinchet Vaikunna Jata Tadosha Dushamanasya Sri Krishna Smaranam Aham Karishye.
So now just chant the holy name and do parikrama for three times.
Hare Krishna, 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 Krishna.